This Southtown school teacher is now suing her school district. She's trying to get her job back.
The teacher says she lost her job because she did not want to return to the classroom. As 7 Eyewitness News reporter Hannah Bueller tells us, this teacher suffers from a serious immune disorder and worries catching COVID-19 could be deadly.
How detrimental would it be for you to go into the classroom?
I can't take that risk. My doctor said you will not be the canary in the coal mine.
For more than two decades, Julie Rizzo has been a Spanish teacher at the East Aurora Central School District.
My enthusiasm for what I do is very tangible.
But for the last year, Rizzo says she has barely left her home. Other than walking her dog, she says a big outing for her is a trip to the car wash. Rizzo says she suffers from a severe immune deficiency disorder and was diagnosed almost 7 years ago at the University of Chicago.
I was told that there are about 3,000 people in the world who have this, and they hadn't seen anybody who represented the way I do.
Rizzo says to supplement her immune system for the past 7 years and the rest of her life, she receives infusions, which take 6 hours every 3 weeks on a Saturday to boost what little immune system she has.
My doctor suspects that I will be highly at risk and possibly die if I catch COVID. So I have been isolated since March.
Rizzo says she had no problem teaching Spanish to her students during lockdown last year from her living room, even receiving high praise for her work. But when East Aurora brought teachers back to the classroom this fall for a hybrid learning model, she says she requested to continue her work from home because of her disability, which was repeatedly denied by the district.
They just said they didn't have a need for anybody to work from home. That's not what the standard is. The standard is to provide her a reasonable accommodation so that she can do her job with her ability.
Court paperwork shows Rizzo was offered by the district the option to teach remotely from a classroom at Parkdale Elementary instead of at the middle school. She says that defeats the purpose entirely.
Do you feel discriminated against by the East Aurora School District?
Yes. And for example, I was told that I could teach from one of their other buildings, but not from my living room, where I have my desk set up and all my computer equipment, and my husband is a tech director, and we have really, really good, you know, a setup here.
According to court paperwork in September, the district sent Rizzo a letter stating the following: being present on campus continues to be an essential function of your job. The needs of the district require its educators to be on campus. The district does not have a need for any teachers to teach remotely from their homes, nor does it have any who are doing so. She was then placed on unpaid leave for the rest of the school year.
Students walk by my house every day and they're like, "We miss you, Senora." And, you know, I'm just letting the dog out. And that's what I'm getting. So it's not just a job. It's not just a paycheck. It is my everything. I've been really, really frustrated and heartbroken.
We've contacted the district numerous times today requesting a statement, and at this point we have not heard back. This discrimination lawsuit has been filed in state Supreme Court. Attorneys for Rizzo are requesting she be put back to her paid job immediately with those work from home accommodations. Reporting in East Aurora, Hannah Bueller, 7 Eyewitness News.